Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today. And today I'm over at Big City Jack's recording studio with Drew from Rose Ellers. And we're going to be testing out the Tierra audio flavours. Now, if any of you are familiar with the cloud lifter, which is used commonly on the SM7B and the Coles 4038, what that is an inline boost, 20 dB boost. So Tierra Audio are a company based in Madrid in Spain, and they're hand-making, essentially, cloud lifters, but each of the different flavours, as they call them, does a slightly different thing. So I have here the full set, the seven in total, and today we're going to be having a look at how they perform on acoustic guitars and on vocals. So to give you an idea of what they look like, this is the truffle. So fairly decent size, really, really rugged build quality. I feel like you could probably run over these in your car and they'd be absolutely fine. They're designed to be road-worn, road-used, taken to live gigs and all that kind of thing, but they're perfectly at home in the studio as well. Now, each of the different flavours comes with this manual, and in there, that tells you what they do and the frequency response of all of them. So, to read out the manual for you, the truffle, it's the most daring and exclusive sound. It brings an abundant amount of saturation, which it does, you'll see in a little bit. The cocoa is a thick, dense character. It basically rolls off treble and adds a little bit of a de-essing effect. The mint is a bright boost, essentially. It's a little bit of a top lift. Great on an SM7B. The chili is our most wild flavour, and without doubt the crispest and the sharpest. Very suitable for vocals because it brings an amazing energy and a lot of presence. The vanilla is creamy and controlled, so that's rolling off a little bit of top and a little bit of bottom. And the pepper is a very defined sound with a pinch of compression. Now the last one is salt. Now salt is basically just neutral and transparent. Now each of these boxes adds its own level of gain. For instance, the truffle is adding 50 dB. The cocoa is adding 42 dB. Mint adds around 27 dB. Chili is 54 dB. Vanilla is 31. Pepper is 32. And salt is also 32. As you can see, these wild and varied amounts of gain boosts. So you're gonna have to dial them in when you use them, you know, from source to source, but generally speaking, I've shot them all out and I can tell you right off the bat, they are really impressive. So let's jump into Pro Tools and I'll show you through the examples and what we recorded, and then I'll give you my final thoughts. All right, so we're here in Pro Tools and we're gonna be having a look at, first things first, some of the pairs that I decided to pair together for you, flavours, so you can kind of hear overall what they do. So first of all, we've got the vanilla on vocal and the pepper on guitar.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do? There's nothing better than a moment with you. Is it any wonder I do?
Next we've got the salt on guitar and the chili on vocal.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do? There's nothing better than a moment with you. Is it any wonder I do?
Finally, we've got the cocoa on guitar and the mint on vocal.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do? There's nothing better than a moment with you. Is it any wonder I do?
And as you can hear, between the different clips, they do bring out subtle different bits of the character. Now, I had Drew record an excerpt from a song called In Dreams by Ben Howard, because it's quite an intricate guitar piece, and I wanted to hear how do the flavours pick up the finger movement and the, you know, the bass notes and things like that. So let's have a listen to these, starting with the salt. Next, we've got the pepper. Next, the vanilla. Next we have the chili. Next we have the mint. Cocoa. Now, finally, the outsider of the bunch, which is the truffle. This one's very, very distorted and really doesn't work on acoustic, but I'll show you anyway. Sounds like shit on guitar, but I could see that one finding its use on something like harmonica or something that has a little bit of grit, maybe even vocal. Something to give it that sort of gritty sound. I did record some soloed vocals as well. Let me jump around a couple of these. Here's the pepper.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do?
And the vanilla.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do?
And the chili.
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do? There's nothing better than a moment with you.
That one to me works really, really well on vocals. Let's try the mint.
Did you ever take a moment or two?
That was a little bit thin sounding. You can really hear the bottom end rolling off there. What about the cocoa?
Did you ever take a moment or two? Is it any wonder I do?
And finally, the truffle.
Did you ever take a moment or two?
Again, with that very heavily distorted sound, would have its place in some rock records, maybe even pop rap records. Maybe if you wanted that really distorted backing vocal sound, it'd be a good way to get it if you didn't want to do it in the box. But overall, I think the chili's probably my favorite on vocals. If we skip back to these opening examples.
Did you ever take a moment or two? I do.
It just sits really, really well. So let me jump back out and I'll give you my final thoughts. All right, so that was my look at the Tierra Audio Flavours. Thanks a lot to Syntax Audio for sending these along for review purposes. I think a personal favourite of mine was either the chili or the vanilla. They really added, although the mint as well, the mint really adds something really nice to the sound, especially on the acoustic. Either way, really great products, very impressive, and do exactly what they say on the tin. Coming into this review, I thought one of two things was going to happen. Either they were going to be absolute garbage and snake oil and barely do anything to the sound, or they were going to be very transformative. I think the realistic scenario is they're somewhere in between. They do something and they clearly add something to the signal, but I don't think on any individual source it's going to be night and day, unless you're talking about the preamps that add distortion. That's very obvious what they're doing. But the general EQ curve ones, they're subtle, but they are definitely there. And I think if you were to track multiple instruments or multiple layers through one of these, the combined effects would become a lot more apparent in a final mix. They're definitely useful, and I can see them being used a lot in the live realm, definitely. Because one of the great things about them is they guarantee that no phantom power will ever pass into the microphone. So if you were to take a salt on the road and you were using a ribbon mic, it doesn't matter what the in-house sound guy is going to do on his desk, and if he accidentally turns phantom on, with one of these your mic will be safe. I'll leave a link in the description below to Tierra Audio's website where you can have a look at them yourself and maybe pick some up. Again, thanks a lot for sending them over for review, appreciate it, and until we meet again, take it easy.
Did you ever take a moment or two?